Let's understand here about the spread operator of JavaScript and what is its usage and where to use it. Let's understand one by one. So I have listed here 4 points. On those 4 points, we'll try to understand the spread operator and the uses of that spread operator. In most of the interview questions of JavaScript, you will get this question from the spread operator, like how you can clone the object, array object, with a spread operator. So starting from the first point, the spread operator is denoted by 3 dots. That means when you are going to write spread operator in some array cloning or in array concatenation or in array merge, that time you can use the 3 dots. 3 dots denote the spread operator. The spread operator unpack elements of iterable objects such as arrays, sets, and map into a list. That means it unpacks the element. Whenever you put a spread operator on iterable like array, set, map, so you can use the rest parameter is also denoted by 3 dots. However, it packs the remaining arguments of a function into an array. That means when somewhere you have seen like a function written like this, function sum x, y, z. I have taken this example from the Mozilla JS site. Sum x, y, z and return x, y, z. And here the numbers are assigned like 1, 2, 3. This is an array number. So I write here console.log sum. Sum is this method and trying to print this sum of this array. So I am just passing here with 3 dots number. I am directly passing the array. And the function is understanding like I am getting these 3 parameters inside. So you can see this expected output 6. When you will console.log this, you will get the expected output 6. And for same here also console.log sum.apply, you can write like this also null and number. I will run these both example to understand here. So suppose I have written this sum function x, y with parameter x, y, z and return the value x plus y plus z. And I have taken one array const numbers equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay. So I will first print the numbers. Numbers you can see here. This is 1, 2, 3. And I am just trying to call this sum method. Sum function. It asks for the value. So okay, I need to pass here numbers. So the expected output is 6. You can see here like it added the here the sum method was having x, y, z and I just passed with 3 dots and the array and it returned me the value 6. So this is what I was calling is that rest parameter. Rest parameter is also denoted by the 3 dots. However, packs the remaining arguments of a function into an array. Means the arguments, whatever the arguments are defined for the function, it will concatenate those arguments in an array list and get to the function. The spread operator can be used to clone an iterable object or merge the iterable object into one. Whenever you are going to use the spread operator, the object should be array, set or map. If the object type is different and it is not iterable, it won't work. In that scenario, it will not work. So moving to next, first usage is here in function parameter like spread operator allow an iterable such as array expression or string to be expanded in place with 0 or more arguments. So whenever you pass more than one argument in a function, you can use this spread operator also in that case. Moving to next uses, constructing array literals. The spread operator allow you to insert another array into the initialized array where you construct an array using the literal form. See the example below. Let me run this example better case to make it understand with the example. So here is initial chars like ABC and one chars left, second char is initial char and add these two C and D means I am trying to insert these two values in the same array which is going to give me the concatenated. So my new array, what this will return a new set of array. So this is the returned array with the other two values. This is how here I am trying to make you understand about this. The spread operator allows you to insert another array into the initialized array, where you construct an array using the literal forms or something. Constructing array, concatenating array. Third use case is concatenating arrays. So if you have more than one array and you want to concatenate those arrays, so there's a function also available. The concatenate function is also available there. You can use that, or you can use this spread operator also to concatenate two arrays into a single one. So let's see this example here. I'm just going to run in this browser window. Identifier number is already declared. You can see here I have already declared the numbers with const. So what I will do, number and put one more s, and here while passing I will put one more s. So now it's returned me undefined, but when I will print this, you can console.log or I will directly print here. You can see here like this 1, 2 is the first array, and 3, 4 are in second array, like numbers s and the more numbers are here two arrays, and I am going to concatenate those two arrays into to get a single one. So here this is the return. If you can console.log it directly, it will return the array. In single line of code, you can merge these two array and you can console.log. Sometimes what happens, like in interview, you will be asked like you have two array and write a single line of code to print those two array contents in a single line of code. So you can just use this console.log. Inside the console.log, you can write like this console.log this two array and close the bracket. So it will print in single line. Single line is printed with this output. Now moving to next one is copying an array. This the JavaScript, most of the interviewer asked for this question, like copying element with the spread operator, or you can call it as a swallow cloning also. Like it is like one dimensional cloning or one tree cloning. If the object is having nested object inside the array, so in that case this swallow cloning will not copy the nested objects. It will only copy the first iterable objects, and the nested objects will be referenced with the previous array, the base array, whatever you have defined there. So moving in this copying, so you can copy an array instance by using a spread operator like this. You can see the example. In any case, whenever you are going to use the spread operator will always return a new array. So you can see here I am going to copy this with a spread operator, and it returned me a new array, which I am just assigning on the copied score. So if you print this copied score, you will get like this value. So if suppose I am going to insert a value inside the copied score dot push, I am going to insert a value 30. So let's see what happens here. This is your four element, and now you can see the score also, it's 3. So this is copied well, so there is no reference inside this. But suppose this array is having some nested key value pair object like nesting, and you are going to use this spread operator to copy. In that case, maybe the first iterable values will be copied and the nested values will be referenced from the previous one in this case. So moving to next one, the optional on a string. This is an optional example I am giving here, like a spread operator on string, how the spread operator operates on a string. So suppose here I have taken one example with characters. You see this is a char. So expected output after running this spread operator, my output, expected output is A, B, C, D. This will be taken as individual elements in this array. So this is actually this is concatenating these things. One this element it will insert inside the, this is a representation of an array. So this is a complete array where this is an element and this is an element, and this is going to concatenate this element inside this. This will return a b c. So this spread operator, if you put a spread operator on a string, it will split each character of that string and will return the new array.